Hello.
あなたたちが刑事さんね。受付から連絡もらったわ。
あなたがこの病院の理事長？
そうよ。女だとは思わなかった？
No.
いや、受付で聞いてはいたんだが。
We had a warning.
少しホームなまりがあるな。
私は BCCH 理事長のクリス・ゴドウィンです。
私は BCP 風紀課のエド・ブラウン。
俺はジョナサン・イングラム。OLA で。
ああ、そうだ。やっぱりそうだわ。どこかで見た顔だと思った。
A fan?
あなたたち、ポリスノーツのエドとジョナサン？
どうして？
私よ。覚えてないかしら？一度少女雑誌のカバーを一緒に撮影したでしょ？もう30年も前だけど。
How old is she?
おう、あのモデルのクリスちゃん？そうか、女らしくなって。
あのクリスか？モデルか。
A little kid?
受付でも言ってたな。
At the time?
もう、すっかりおばちゃんよ。そうね、あなたたちなの。会えて嬉しいわ。で、どんな用件？
Okay, that was unexpected. Okay, I didn't know that was gonna happen either. So let's look around as we normally do, and we'll talk to her. Ed says, these are books on organ transplantation. That's my area of expertise. They're all books about organ transplantation. I wrote a few of them myself. They're really old, though. I'm probably the only doctor on the colony who keeps so much paper media around. Ed says, they look complicated. I don't think they'd make much sense to us. Okay, so all these, alright. Okay, what's this? What are all these papers? Jonathan asks. I've got things like my medical license and the hospital's accreditation up there. I said that right, right? Accreditation? There are documents hanging all over the walls, Jonathan says. This place really feels like a director's office. Because it is. Pictures!
Chris's kid?
That's... ...他人の子供よ.
The music.
君の子供じゃないの?
Jonathan, よせ。
悪かった。
Well, we gotta find out. It played the suspenseful music and everything. Jonathan says, you seem a little sad for someone your age. I was 19, if I remember right. It's Chris in her teens. She's holding a baby. It's a newborn baby. I don't even remember his name. He's a cute little guy. So what did he give him? She gave him up for adoption or something like that? So why does she have the picture on display if it's a touchy subject? Beyonds. Cool! Oh, that's the picture they were talking about. It's the cover of a teen magazine from 30 years ago. That's awesome. They've got us and the other Policenauts on the front. Chris says, seeing you guys brings back so many memories. Okay, well, this is Jonathan. This was me before I lost everything. And this is, what's her name? Chris. I remember how cute you were, Chris. Ed says, yeah, real cute. I would have been 14 then. This is, well, that's Ed, and this must be, what's his name? Who's now the chief of BCCP? Gates, right? Ed says, there's Gates, he was Mr. Popular. And here's Ed, who looks less black here. I was just a kid back then myself. And this is, the Italian guy, Salvatore. It says he always joked around when we did pictures like this. And this is Mr. Tokugawa. He never smiles for the camera. This magazine had the largest circulation on Beyond at the time, Ed said. It's called Beyonds. It's a general interest magazine. I thought it was a teen magazine. Issue number 10. It's the October 2013 issue. Alright, done. Got it. What's this? Jonathan says. It's potpourri. It has a lavender fragrance. I got it sent to me by a friend on home. Go ahead and smell it. Oh, like a new smell. It's lavender potpourri. Yeah, it does smell like lavender. Lavender's a nice smell. Is this a fireplace? Jonathan asks. Yeah, but I don't use it. You're not allowed to use fireplaces on Beyond. It's just for decoration. This is marble, isn't it? Pretty extravagant decoration. We can light it. It's a fireplace. It's funny. You feel warmer just looking at it. Light? So we can't light it? Sorry, but it isn't built for actual fires. Chris says, are you listening to me at all? Oh, I don't have the option anymore. How about this chair? That's a nice chair. It better be. I spent half my life sitting on it. It's Chris's chair. What about this? Is this a purse?
その手に持っているものは?
マスキートよ.
Oh. Mosquito.
マスキート?
Yep. Hey.
蚊型の採血マイクロマシンよ。このマスキート、プログラムがいかれちゃって制御できないの。ようやく先回収したのよ。
I can tell you more about it if you're interested. Sure. This type of medical micro machine is used on a colony for drawing blood. I guess we ask her about it. Nice dress. Smell, we can smell her. You know, if you told me you're a model, you're still a model, I believe you, Jonathan says. Ed says, I don't think I've seen anyone look this good in a lab coat before. Oh, Ed, you've been taking notes from Jonathan? Does she know Jonathan that well already? I would never, ever guess you're in your 40s, Jonathan says. What would you guess? Late 20s, tops. That's awfully nice of you, Jonathan. Smell? That's a nice smell. It's the same as that potpourri, isn't it? Yeah. It's a lavender perfume. I just hate the smell of drugs. That's the only reason I wear it. And it says you get about as many people wearing fragrances here as you do smoking cigarettes. Hey, Jonathan says. Nothing wrong with that either. Nothing wrong with either. Suits you perfectly. I keep smelling her. Anything to say about her hair then? Nope. Are we gonna focus on her legs? Jonathan says, you've got legs from here to some wonderful place. Chris says, well, I can tell you they're not as nice as they used to be. Certainly nothing compared to any young girl out there. Ed says, I wish she'd keep him in one place. She making you uncomfortable, Ed? Come on, don't do this to me. I promise you they're not as nice as you think. We can smell her legs? Oh, just smelling her. Alright, I don't suppose anything about the necklace. Oh, yep, yeah, I wasn't expecting that. Alright, let's talk to her finally.
実は行方不明になったある人物の足取りを追っている北条健三という。王女？聞かないわね。ここの患者なの? その男、徳川製薬のプロパーなんだ。徳川製薬でこの病院に薬を卸してるって聞いたんだ。
ここの薬関係の担当者を紹介してもらえないか。
ああ、それなら薬局の薬剤師に聞けばわかるはずよ。ここの薬の管理はすべて彼に任してるから。それで？
Ask about Hojo. Jonathan says, so you don't know anything at all about Hojo? The littlest thing could help. No, this is the first I've heard of him. I'm sorry. He would have dealt mainly with the pharmacist when he was here. The pharmacy? You have your own pharmacy here? Beyond has the same medical system you find in Japan, where a doctor can also serve as a pharmacist. When people get their prescription in the hospital, they'll receive their medication from its pharmacy. We have our own pharmacy since there's no separation between prescribing and dispensing in our medical industry. The profit margin for drugs here is astronomical, Ed says. Doctors rake in an extra 20-30% by dispensing themselves. Hospitals and drug companies make a killing in this system because the price for drugs for patients is so high. One of the reasons Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals become so successful is because it lobbied for the implementation of the Japanese system on Beyond in the early days of the colony. Plus, there's the fact that people here prefer to take a drug for something even if they don't actually need it. All this has led to overprescription, a high drug profit margin, and a medical industry that benefits doctors and hospitals instead of patients. Chris says, personally, I'm against doing things this way. We should be working on separating the industry like places on home. But as a businesswoman, it's great for us. The hospital wouldn't be where it is today without this system. Jonathan says, yeah, I get all that, but what about the pharmacist? Oh yeah, the pharmacist. You mean Jun Ishina? Yeah. What can you tell me about this Ishina? Ed says. Jun Ishida is an employee of Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals assigned to us here at the hospital. He can be a bit of an odd character, but he gets the job done. Jonathan says he works with Tokugawa. We have an important relationship with Tokugawa. A number of their employees work here. We could never just shut them out. He's a Nisei Beyond. He hasn't got much of a personality, really. None of them do. I only talk to him when it's work-related. Okay, the pharmacy's location. Where's the pharmacy located, Jonathan asks. Through that door there. The two rooms were originally one. It's a little inconvenient, I know. We split this room up, and that's where we put the pharmacy. The window's out in the hall, of course. Ed says, you make sure no one steals anything, huh? I guess you could say that. We're planning on moving it soon, since it's been a pain having it like this for so long. Okay, we can ask about herself. Jonathan says, so how did the Miss Teen Beyond wind up in charge of the colony's biggest hospital? I quit modeling 20 years ago. My patients were doctors here. But then they were killed in a space plane disaster. That's when I inherited this place. Did she say her patients? Her parents were doctors here, sorry. I was like, that makes no sense. I'd gone to medical school and this was the only thing they left me. I'm always busy with something, whether it's here or somewhere else. You marry, Chris? Nope. I've never had much time for relationships with work. I've devoted my life to my career. Guys stopped showing any interest in me a long time ago anyway. Jonathan says, I find that very, very hard to believe. Are you saying you'd be interested? So he asks, whose child is that in the photo? Son of a friend. Yeah, somehow I don't believe that. Something up about that. Before I forget, Chris says, I don't mind when you say things like that to me, but leave that poor receptionist alone, okay? You heard about that already? You must have more important things to talk about than me, don't you? Her job. I'll talk about your job instead. My main job is running the hospital, but since my area of expertise is organ transplantation, I help out a little with that as well. For instance, I'm a consultant for the Beyond Coast Organ Distribution Network, the Beyond Coast Organ Procurement Network, and various other transplant groups. I also volunteer as a psychiatric nurse, working between transplant coordinators, donors, and recipients. Jonathan says, are organ transplants really that important in space? Yeah, they're absolutely essential to us. Space's environment has massive effects on the human body. What with the weightlessness and cosmic rays, we still aren't ready for transplanting artificial organs. All medical science can do at the moment is transplant them from other people. Oh, we got more stuff opened up. Ed asks, what are the dangers of organ transplants? In the past, the biggest problem was post-op rejection, but we've overcome that with the development of Tokugawa's immunosuppressant cyclosporine, however you say that, as well as mass transplants, which don't trigger rejection. What are mass transplants? Jonathan asks. It's a revolutionary procedure that's eliminated rejections in recipients. With it, we're able to mask the organ's HLA class 1 antigens before transplantation. Ed says, I'm not too familiar with it, but with its introduction, the number of organ transplants has risen dramatically. The success rates of transplants have gone up, while the side effects of immunosuppressants have gone down. We've made countless advancements in procedures, preservation methods, and tissue compatibility tests over the years. Technologically speaking, we've cleared every hurdle. The only real problem would be the shortage of donors. We finally established a consensus for determining brain death after the turn of the century, but a number of issues have allowed a donor shortage to continue. We have the technology, but it's useless without enough donors. Jonathan says Karen's waiting for a donor herself. Artificial organs. Jonathan says, what about using artificial organs temporarily? We're a long way from developing organs that can be used long-term, function as a complete replacement for the failed organ, and be small enough to be inserted into the body. We do have machine organs and bio-organs, but the only replacements that can currently be classified as complete are artificial bones, teeth, and a type of blood used exclusively for transporting oxygen. Jonathan says, you're talking about the artificial blood AP uses. There are machines that can function as supplementary hearts and kidneys outside the body, but there are problems with internalizing them. The most advanced artificial kidney I can ever see us developing is continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis. Okay, whatever that is. Are there any organs you could never replace? I'd say the liver, the pancreas, and the gastrointestinal organs. There are hybrid types in development that combine organic tissue and synthetic materials, but they're still testing them on animals right now. The only place you'd find cyborgs for now are movies and video games and the like. We can't play God at everything, perhaps. Okay, radiation. Which organs are affected by cosmic rays? The ones with rapid cell division rates are affected the most. For instance, bone marrow, lymphatic tissue, the mucosal epithelium of the digestive tract, the reproductive organs. Jonathan says that's what happened to Karen. Then come the kidneys, the liver. We know that happened to her reproductive organs? How do we know that? I don't remember saying that. Then come the kidneys, the liver, the lungs, the skin, blood vessels. The effects on sperm and fetuses are the most pronounced. Yeah, I know about that, Jonathan says. You had to avoid conceiving for at least 6 months after returning from space before. The time frame's been reduced, but amphibians still had to be careful with that. You mentioned brain death? Brain death is different from persistent vegetative state. In persistent vegetative state, the cerebral cortex stops functioning while the brain stem continues to work normally. Some people differentiate between total brain death and brain stem death, but in both cases, the brain stem, which, basically speaking, regulates the body's life support system, stops functioning. There are many criteria involved in determining brain death. Before, these varied from country to country, but now we have a worldwide consensus for declaring a person brain dead. The donation of organs or tissue from a brain-dead individual is based on the doctrine of informed consent from either the individual, when still mentally competent, or the individual's family or caregiver. Bone marrow transplants. Jonathan says, this doesn't have anything to do with our investigation, but how complex a procedure is a bone marrow transplant? Well, all transplants are complex procedures, but bone marrow transplants in particular. You can't perform the transplant without a donor whose HLA matches the recipient's. I wonder if Jonathan does. match Karen. Everything depends on them matching. The problem doesn't hinge on the procedure itself as much as finding a donor. We know someone who's waiting for a bone marrow transplant, Jonathan says. Do they have any siblings? None. In that case, it won't be easy. You need a donor with matching HLA. You can't do the transplant otherwise. You look impressed, Jonathan, Ed says. I guess. Now, you notice he didn't flirt at all with Karen. I mean, it would be totally improper and messed up in the first place. I mean, her father's missing and her mother died. And it's her mother's daughter. So I'm guessing they... Just guessing, guys. They don't become involved. But rather, he finds out that she's actually his daughter. Right? Not Kenzo's daughter. Thus, he can give her the bone marrow transplant. If you guys know, I mean, don't say anything, of course. Just like to guess where things go. Alright, so, mosquitoes. It's a mosquito-type robot developed by Tokugawa Heavy Industries and Pharmaceuticals. It's designed for drawing blood from people and animals and administering shots. With this, you can draw blood without the subject feeling a thing. That's great. It can also be used for donating blood. They've received a lot of criticism, but these guys are one of the reasons we've been able to prevent AIDS and other diseases here. Johnson says they fly by flapping their wings. They were designed through biomechanics. I don't know the details. We saw a hologram of it at Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals, Ed says. Uh-oh. Well, what's loaded into it? What's it gonna give us? It gives shots.
Jonas-san, kabe ni tomatta wa.
Am I gonna...
Tsukamaete. Soto ni dasu to taihen da wa.
I don't have to shoot that thing.
Cursor de click suru nda. Shinchou ni na.
It's gonna be hard, though. Yeah.
So, nigerareta.
So. On her nose.
Atashi no hana ni.
Chris, jitto shiteru nda. Umokanai you ni.
Give me the cursor.
また逃げられた。
I hit it, didn't I?
ダメ。 早く捕まえて。
You're talking to us and the mosquito.
美味しいところに泊まりやがった。
Oh, jeez.
ジョナサン、俺に任せろ。断る。俺が頼まれた。
No, you do it, Ed. I can't get over there.
こいつ、また逃げられるのがオチだ。
二人とも、早く捕まえてよ。
申し訳ない。
Oh.
そう、また逃げられた。
He cursed again.
刺されたわ。
What drug is loaded into it? Oh.
やだ。こんなところに。
お、今度は胸だ。
Oh boy.
五章だから、ジョナーさん、俺の役目だ。俺は人生を恨むよ。
I hate my life.
また逃げられた。ジョナサン。
It's too small. And I can't control the cursor. Fine, like fine operation.
お願い、早く捕まえて。
Trying. I can't move it. It moves past.
くそ、また逃げられた。ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
お願い、早く捕まえて。
This is ridiculous.
また逃げられた。ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
I have to slow down the cursor.
お願い、早く捕まえて。
くそ、また逃げられた。ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
All right, let's slow it down.
お願い、早く捕まえて。
Can I change the cursor speed right now? No, I can't do anything. Oh, damn it.
また逃げられた。ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
Just get it, Ed. Just do it.
お願い、早く捕まえて。
I did.
そう、また逃げられた。ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
お お願い、早く捕まえて。
I clicked it.
また逃げられた。
Oh boy.
ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
お願い、早く捕まえて。
Ah,
そう、また逃げられた。
This is ridiculous.
ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
お願い、早く捕まえて。
I clicked it.
そう、また逃げられた。
ジョナサン、真面目にやれ。
お願い、早く捕まえて。
Oh, jeez. I did not do it on purpose that time.
やった、触った、触った。
I got it.
ありがとう、ジョナサン。
いや、こんなことならいつでも。
Oh, jeez.
ジョナサン、お前な、後で感想を聞かせろよ。
本当におかしな人たちね。Policenauts さん。
Speaking of a pair.
まるでバディ映画から抜け出たみたい。
Yeah.
ま、大事に至らなくてよかった。
そうね。さあ、これからどうする？お二人さん。
Haha. Okay. Like we were saying. Anything else to say about this now?He was a tough little bastard, Jonathan says. They can be dangerous if a group of them malfunctions. A swarm nearly killed a dog once. They sucked its blood? Yeah, it got into a testing area. They put it down to a programming error. And so I'm surprised they ever let them on the market. It's only because they were made by Tokugawa. They tend to break down a lot. They can be more trouble than they're worth.Jonathan says, you have got a fantastic body. Those look absolutely delicious. I go to zero-G salons and spend time in the zero-G ward, so gravity hasn't had its way with me too much. Oh, Ed says, you really got to watch your words around this guy. That's just asking for trouble. I still can't believe I touched those. And look, we can do it again, apparently. Boy, are they the elephant in the room. Or two baby elephants.It says, I really do hate my life. Or he thinks it. Something like that. Hold still. There's a fly on you now, Jonathan says. I'm sure she believes you. Oh, brother. Oh, she's bigger than the stewardess, Jonathan says. This is ridiculous. I had no idea you were this perverted, though. Why do these girls just let him do this?The receptionist told me to watch out with you. Now I see what she was talking about. Doctor? Yeah? Okay, so we can show her the Hojo photo. This is a photo of Hojo. I have met him before.I may have met him before. I'm not sure, though. He looks like your typical serious Tokugawa employee, she says. Wow, I remember this photo. Look at you. You're all so young and handsome. Now, before I get in more trouble...I'm sure showing people this ID is not a good idea. That's a Tokugawa ID, right? I'm surprised they lent that to you. And she's not saying much, but I'm gonna just be careful and restore.This is going to be a long LP. All these episodes were still on Act 1. I think there's like 5 acts or something. Okay, I guess we're done in here. go to the pharmacy.
じゃ、薬局を見せてもらうよ。
どうぞ、そこの扉よ。あ、ジョナサン。
なんだい。
そのタバコ、なんとかならない。
Smoking?
これか。
医者としては黙認できないんだけど。
香水好きの女性としてなら黙認できるだろう。
OK よ。脅迫がうまいわね。
男と女の駆け引きさ。
It's only defense, huh? Hi.
何の用だいあんたら。薬なら窓口で。
心配はいらない。俺たちは BCP のものだ。理事長の許可は得ている。
警察？
石田さんでしょ、薬局の責任者の。
はあ、僕は石田純だけど、一応ここの薬局を任されてるけど。で、どんな用件なんだい？